Hey, welcome again to the new episode of Massive Lab Academy. My name is Obiorito Wise, of course. Today we are going to look at the titration of calcium hydroxide against hydrochloric acid. And I just want to first begin by measuring 1 gram of calcium hydroxide. So put in one like that. It is calcium hydroxide. The next thing that I'll do is to transfer this mass of calcium hydroxide in a volumetric glass. Carefully. Once I've done that, ladies and gentlemen, the next thing that I do is to add about 50 centimeter cube of water inside that. Next thing that I do is to just shake it a bit away and add some other 40. About 40, that's okay. Then I'll shake again. So once I've done that, I will now filter the resulting solution and label it D. So it's my final solution. So I want to filter this. So I just think need to defy from this. And on the other side, in the dry bread, just do something here. So once I have rinsed it, now, this is my hydrochloric acid to a tune of 0.07 molar. This is hydrochloric acid, 0.07 molar. So I wish now to pour it inside here. And what I'll do is just want to make sure that no errors here. Close it carefully. Then I will now add there is my HCl. The zero mark. So I'm gonna reduce this. Now the next thing I do is to pipette about 25 of this final solution of hydroxide. Yeah. The next thing I do is to put it inside here, the conical flask. Mm-hmm. once I've done that, now it's my turn to do the titration. So I'll add about 2 to 3 drops of, this means the orange. So 2 to 3 drops. So this is the initial color. So I want to titrate until this color change. I can do another trial, of course, second one, the third one I can predict, of course, that range. So what can I do is to remove this and bring this back. Just need to add more of this. So I will add more. Just be patient, because I need 25, about 25 of this. Transfer this here. And I proceed. Some M molecule. Get some accurate measurement from this. This needs 25. I to the point. Once I've done that, I will add 2 to 3 drops. So I'll count 1. I think that is enough. Plus 1 big drop there. So now my initial is 15 now. So I start continuing the process. Compare this and this. Yeah. Compare them to really know what happens. So now at this point I didn't drop my drop. Just want to see the color change. Timing now. Next one to be around 14. So that could be 3. So this is 1. That's will be the results, ladies and gentlemen. And that's how to carry out a titration or prepare. If you're preparing for your students, now you know what to do. You just need to give each of the students 1 gram of calcium hydroxide, and then ask them, of course, to pour that calcium hydroxide inside a volumetric flask and add some 90 centimeter cube of water, and then filter it. And from the filter, they can pipe at 25 into the conical flask and titrate against 0.07. Of the HCl. And that's how it can work, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe to this channel and share the video, and help us by supporting us and sharing the video to reach 1,000 subscribers. My name is Gary Tobias. That's all for today.